So welcome to our next lecture. Dear students, we are discussing on solar photovoltaic systems. In the last period, we have seen what is mean by solar energy. Then we have also discussed about fundamentals of semiconducting materials. Then we have seen what is mean by P-type semiconductor. What is mean by N-type semiconductor? How to obtain these P-type and N-type semiconductors? What is doping? What is mean by tetravalent, pentavalent, and trivalent elements? When we get P-type semiconductor, when we get N-type semiconductor, how to dope it with P-type or the pentavalent or trivalent impurity? So all this discussion we have done in our previous video. Now, with the assumption that you all know about semiconductor, P-type semiconductor, and N-type semiconductor, now we will proceed to our next topic, that is P-N junction. Our next topic is P-N junction. So simply, saying, we can say that when P-type and N-type semiconductors are joined together, a P-N junction is formed at the boundary. So what is the meaning? Simply, suppose we are having, suppose this is P-type semiconductor, and suppose this is N-type semiconductor, then if we join these two pieces of semiconductor together, then what will happen? A P-N junction gets formed at the interface. Rather saying boundary, we will say interface. Interface of the two materials or two pieces. The simply that means if this is p-type, and if we join this n-type semiconductor like this to p-type semiconductor, then what will happen? This is called as interface or boundary of the two semiconducting materials. So at the boundary or at the junction, what we call it as a P-N junction is formed when we join P and N type materials with each other. So in simplest manner, we can say when P type material is joined to N type semiconductor material, a P-N junction is formed at the boundary or at the interface of the two materials. Now, actually, what happens when we join the two types of semiconducting materials, the entire picture changes drastically. Tremendously, the picture changes. Now, what I mean by change in the picture is that, suppose we are having, this is P-type semiconductor material. Ek aaya hai, P-type semiconductor. This is P-type. So P-type madhe aapnala maiti, now we know that in case of P-type material, there are holes as a majority charge carriers. Mukhyatve karun P-type material madhe kay astat? Holes astat mothya pramanamadhe. So holes we denote by plus sign. So plus sign indicates holes. Holes are in majority number in P-type semiconductor, because we have doped the pure semiconductor by trivalent impurity so as to get P-type semiconductor. This we have seen in the previous video. Now, at the same time, this P-type material consists of small number of or few number of electrons in it. So these electrons are far less in number as compared to the holes. So they are called as minority carriers, minority charge carriers. So as far as p-type semiconductor material is concerned, holes are majority carriers and electrons are minority carriers. So when this piece of p-type semiconductor is kept ideal, isolated, then nothing happens. Nothing will happen. It will be simply there as it is. Similarly, if we go for n-type semiconductor material, in n-type, there consist of large number of electrons as a minority, majority carriers, and few number of holes as minority carriers. So as far as this n-type material or piece of n-type material is kept isolated, left as it is, then also nothing will happen in it. But now when we come to the p-n junction, when we join these two pieces of semiconducting material, one being p-type and other being n-type, what happens? The scenario changes very fast, quickly. What happens actually? What changes it there took place? Let us now understand. Now, before joining, one thing is clear to you, that it should be clear to you that as far as this n-type material is concerned, it consists of large number of electrons. All electrons are negatively charged, so there will be mutual repulsion between them. त्यांच्यामध्ये काय आहे, म्युच्युअल रिपल्शन आहे, बिकॉज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर निगेटिव्हली चार्ज. सो बिकॉज ऑफ म्युच्युअल रिपल्शन दे विल बी हॅव्हिंग टेंडन्सी टू गो अवे फ्रॉम इच अदर, बट दे कॅनॉट लीव दिस बाउंड्री ऑफ द मटेरियल इट सेल्फ. नो इलेक्ट्रॉन कॅन जम्प आउट ऑफ द पीस, आउट ऑफ द एन टाइप मटेरियल. Similar situation is there also in case of holes. Also, holes being positively charged, there is mutual repulsion, but holes also cannot jump out of the p-type material even if there is a mutual repulsion, because there is a actually that in there should be sufficient energy to cross over the boundaries of the material itself, isn't it? So because of that, the situation, the scenario doesn't change anymore. As far as the pieces are kept isolated, they are away from each other. Now, but when we join these together, join with each other, then let us see what happens or what will happen. So now I will draw here. This is p-type and this is n-type semiconductor. Both we are joined together and p-n junction has been formed. P-n junction tayar zhalele. So this boundary is called as junction or p-n junction. Okay. Now, as told earlier, there exist large number of holes in it. And in n-type semiconductor, there exist large number of electrons in it. Okay. Now, as told earlier to you, there is a mutual repulsion between the electrons. Now, these electrons under the repulsive force will try to diffuse across the junction. Here is a junction, here is a boundary, या बाउंड्रीच्या इकडं इकडचा इलेक्ट्रॉन याची शक्यता आता नाकारता येत नाही. और अदर इट विल क्रॉस द जंक्शन अँड विल एंटर इन टू द पी टाईप रिजन, इजंट इट. नाऊ लेट इज अज्युम दॅट दिस दिस पर्टिक्युलर इलेक्ट्रॉन, नाऊ ऑब्विसली द इलेक्ट्रॉन विच इज नियर टू द जंक्शन विल फर्स्ट बी एबल टू क्रॉस द जंक्शन, है ना. जो इलेक्ट्रॉन जंक्शनच्या जवळ आहे तो काय करेल, जंक्शनला क्रॉस करायचा प्रयत्न करेल. लांबचा इलेक्ट्रॉन, इथला इलेक्ट्रॉन, इथला इलेक्ट्रॉन इतकं इथून इकडे येऊन इकडे क्रॉस करणार नाही, कारण काय होईल, इथे येत्या तर त्याची एनर्जी बऱ्यापैकी कमी होऊन जाईल, त्याच्यामुळे इट विल नॉट बी एबल टू क्रॉस द जंक्शन. बट द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विच आर नियर द जंक्शन दे विल ट्राय टू क्रॉस ऑर डिफ्यूज अक्रॉस द जंक्शन, इजंट इट. सो लेट अस अज्यूम दॅट वन ऑफ सच इलेक्ट्रॉन विच इज नियर टू द जंक्शन डिफ्यूजेस अक्रॉस द जंक्शन. हा समजा इलेक्ट्रॉन होता, हा जो पर्टिक्युलर इलेक्ट्रॉन आहे तो काय झाला, हा इकडं असा आला. इट कम्स इन द पी टाईप रिजन. नाउ ॲज सून ॲज इट कम्स इन द पी टाईप रिजन व्हॉट हॅपन्स, इट फाउंड्स लार्ज नंबर ऑफ होल्स नियर द जंक्शन इन द पी टाईप रिजन. सो ऑब्विसली इलेक्ट्रॉन इज अ निगेटिव्हली चार्ज, होल इज अ पॉझिटिव्हली चार्ज, सो दे अट्रॅक्ट इच अदर, ऑर वी कॅन से द इलेक्ट्रॉन फील्स द होल, it recombines, it combines with the hole and it will get settled there in the hole, we can say. So now after this, this is called as diffusion, diffusion across the junction. So we have said that one electron in n-type semiconductor has diffused across the junction and it has recombined with the hole. So what will happen due to this recombination process? So there are two things. First thing is that here the atom of which this electron has been moved across the junction, this atom will be having one electron less in number. As a result, this atom will behave as having net positive charge on it. अगेन आय विल रिपीट, हा जो इलेक्ट्रॉन आहे एन टाईप सेमीकंडक्टर मधला, तो कुठल्या ना कुठल्या ऍटम सोबत रिलेटेड असेल, ऍटमशी कनेक्टेड असेल, तर त्या ऍटमला तो इलेक्ट्रॉन सोडून देईल आणि तो पी टाईप सेमीकंडक्टर मधलं जे एखादं होल आहे त्याच्यामुळे तो फील होऊन जाईल. तर ज्या ऍटम पासून हा इलेक्ट्रॉन वेगळा होऊन तो निघालेला आहे, तो ऍटमला एक इलेक्ट्रॉनची संख्या कमी होईल किंवा त्या ऍटम मधील इलेक्ट्रॉनची संख्या एक ने कमी होईल, त्याच्यामुळं त्या ऍटम वरचा नेट चार्ज काय राहील, नेट चार्ज ऑन द ऍटम विल बी पॉझिटिव्ह. सो दिस पर्टिक्युलर ऍटम विल बिहेव ॲज अ पॉझिटिव्ह आयन. सो वी विल डिनोट फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अँड होल्स विथ negative and positive sign. On the other hand, we will denote ions by circled symbols of negative and positive. So circled plus sign will indicate a positive ion. On the similar way, this electron will recombine with one of the hole in the p-type semiconductor. So the hole to the atom to which the hole was belonging, now that hole, that atom will be having one electron in excess. त्याच्यातले त्या ऍटम इथं ज्या ऍटम मधील होल सोबत इलेक्ट्रॉन कंबाईन झालेला आहे त्या ऍटम मध्ये इलेक्ट्रॉनची संख्या एक ने जास्त होईल आणि त्याच्यामुळं तो पर्टिक्युलर ऍटम जो आहे दॅट विल बिहेव ॲज अ निगेटिव्ह आयन, isn't it? So how to represent this negative ion? I will redraw this picture now. This is junction and now this is positive ion just created and this is negative ion. So this happens as soon as the junction is formed, isn't it? Now, एक इलेक्ट्रॉन के फक्त डिफ्यूज होणार नाही, साइमल्टेनियसली अलॉंग विथ द फर्स्ट व्हेरी फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन देर मे बी लार्ज नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स डिफ्यूजिंग अक्रॉस द जंक्शन. सो लेट अस अज्यूम दैट दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑल्सो डिफ्यूजेस अक्रॉस द जंक्शन एंड द करस्पॉन्डिंग एटम बिकम्स पॉजिटिव आयन. इट क्रॉसेस द बाउंड्री, इट फिल्स द होल एंड द करस्पॉन्डिंग एटम बिकम्स negative ion. Similarly, one more electron we can show here. This also diffuses across the junction, leaves behind the positive ion, and here it combines with the hole, creating one more negative ion. So now you observe this picture. Now here what we see is here that near the junction in p-type region, a wall of negative ions has been created very soon after the junction has been formed. After the formation of junction, in a very lesser time, a wall of negative ions is created in p-type semiconductor. On the other hand, in n-type semiconductor, soon after the formation of junction, a wall of positive ions is also built up or created near the junction. Now let us again assume that this particular electron now tries to cross across the junction. Now what will happen? Now suppose this electron tries to cross across the junction. So when this electron will try to cross across the junction, what will happen? This negative ion will now repel the incoming electron from n-type semiconductor into the p-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor मधून येणाऱ्या इलेक्ट्रॉनला आता मात्र काय होईल, p-type semiconductor च्या मध्ये जंक्शनच्या जवळ जी negative ion ची वॉल तयार झालेली आहे, हा इलेक्ट्रॉन येत असेल तर ही वॉल negative ion ची आहे, तो काय करेल, it will repel back the incoming electron from the n-type semiconductor. So now this electron will not be able to diffuse across the junction. So it will not diffuse, or we can say the diffusion will stop. Kai Wilmer, the diffusion will stop. Diffusion stop means ka stop will karan ka ye aata kai will the negative ion chi wall क्रॉस होऊ देणार नाही, डिफ्यूज होऊ देणार नाही इलेक्ट्रॉनला. आणि मग समजा आपण असे अजून पुढे एखाद्या इलेक्ट्रॉनला जायचंच असेल तिकडं, या इफ स्टील सम ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द एन टाईप रिजन वॉन्ट्स टू डिफ्यूज इन टू द एन पी टाईप रिजन, देन व्हॉट शुड इट हॅव ऑर व्हॉट शुड इट डू, इट शुड ओव्हरकम दिस निगेटिव्ह फोर्स, दिस रिपल्सिव्ह फोर्स. This is, in more correctly words, is said it as it has to overcome this barrier. This actually, this wall of negative ions and wall of positive, similarly is the case for positive ions holes also. Hole la degli ikada jata hai karan ikadchi positive ion chi wall tala repel karte. So in turn we can say that now after the formation of junction, a wall of positive ions and negative ions is built up near the junction, and this wall of ions opposes the diffusion of charge carriers across the junction. Across the junction, charge carriers la diffuse ho det nahi. So if we want to have the diffusion now, then first of all, this charge carriers has to overcome the barrier set up by the negative and positive ion walls. So rather, more correctly, we can say now this wall of negative and positive ions will act as a barrier to the diffusion, and that's why this, more correctly, it is called as barrier potential. It is called as barrier potential. So you can see here also, if we if we see here, this is negative and this is positive. So this negative terminal we can say, and this is positive, positive negative. So what will happen? This internal wall of ions will create a potential difference across the junction, or we can say at the junction, and that potential will be having sign as shown in the figure. P type madhe hai negative, it will be acting as a negative terminal, we can say negative potential, and it will be as a positive potential, and in general it will be called as a barrier potential. It is called as barrier potential. So now if any free charge carrier in n type or in p type semiconductor in p-n junction has to diffuse across the junction, then it should overcome this barrier potential, isn't it? So it should have sufficient energy to overcome the barrier potential, then and only then it can cross across the junction. So this is the concept of barrier potential, and this is what happens after formation of p-n junction. P type semiconductor vegla ahe, n type semiconductor vegla ahe, teva kahi farak vishesh kahi hot nahi, parantu as soon as we form the p-n junction, in the next moment what happens, a barrier potential is developed at the junction, and now which stops, which opposes the diffusion process, and if electron or hole has to diffuse across the junction, then they should be able to overcome this barrier potential setup at the junction. So this is the first thing that happens after formation of barrier, after formation of p-n junction. Now we can understand this entire phenomena or entire concept in different ways. So let us go ahead, let us move ahead, and let us see how to do that. So we have come to this point. When p-type and n-type semiconductors are joined together, a p-n junction is formed at the boundary. This is because the electrons in n-type portion would diffuse across the joining boundary in p-type region, and similarly the holes in p-type portion would diffuse across joining boundary in the n-type region until a voltage equal to the sum of diffusion potentials of electron and holes is established across p and n junction. So this is what I have explained to you. हे डिफ्यूजन कुठपर्यंत होत राहील, जोपर्यंत डिफ्यूजन पोटेन्शियल तिथं डेव्हलप होणार नाही, किंवा वॉल ऑफ निगेटिव्ह आयन आणि वॉल ऑफ पॉझिटिव्ह आयन डेव्हलप होणार नाही तोपर्यंत डिफ्यूजन होत नाही. आणि एकदा पूर्ण वॉल बिल्डअप झाली की मात्र काय होईल, डिफ्यूजन ते स्टॉप होऊन जाईल. सो दिस इज व्हॉट आय, सो दॅट इज द व्होल्टेज, ऑर वी कॅन से दिस व्होल्टेज नथिंग बट बॅरियर व्होल्टेज ऑर बॅरियर पोटेन्शियल इन द रिजन ऑफ जंक्शन. A permanent electric field is established. This permanent electric field means काय आहे, barrier potential. So this barrier, as far as there is a p-n junction, कोणतेही p-n junction तुम्ही घ्या, हा p type आहे, हा n type आहे. Whenever there is a p-n junction, there is a permanent electric field within the p-n junction, and that permanent electric field opposes the diffusion across the junction. Of the diffusion of charge carriers across the junction. So it is the internal field of the p-n junction that is to be kept in the mind. It is internally built up. So such a p-n junction solar cell, such a p-n junction solar, now this p-n junction will act as a solar cell. Our point is, whatever, now this you have studied, actually this p-n junction we call simply as a diode. This is diode, semiconductor diode. So this diode can act as a solar cell. Such a p-n junction solar cells in practice can be realized in several ways, including implanting, diffusing or growing n-type impurity into p-type crystal, or p-type impurity into n-type crystal. So this is said how to generate this p-n junction. So we p-type madhe n-type diffuse kara, so n-type madhe p-type kara. वेगवेगळ्या प्रोसेसने आपण काय करू शकतो पी एन जंक्शन डायोड्स किंवा विच विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ सोलर सेल्स दॅट विल बी मॅन्युफॅक्चर दॅट विल बी ग्रोन डेव्हलप्ड इजंट इट सो वी विल स्टॉप हियर अँड इन द नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ वी विल अगेन डिस्कस दिस पॉइंट इन रिगार्ड टू फर्मी एनर्जी और एनर्जी लेवल्स व्हॉट हॅपन्स टू द फर्मी एनर्जी लेवल after having formed the p-n junction that we will discuss in the next chapter. Okay, so by the time we will stop here.